Good evening, everyone. Today we have amongst us Dr. Surendra Kapoor. He's renowned in the field of aura cleansing, dream interpretation, and Vedic Jyotish. So let me begin by asking a question. How many of us know that we have a negligible energy field around our body and we call it as aura? So we're going to talk about aura cleansing today. But before we begin, let me give it to sir. So sir, since you are an expert in aura cleansing, so would you throw some light on what aura is all about actually?
Good evening. Aura is truly extension of your physical body. Your physical body can be photographed and there is your picture. But what is inside your thoughts comes out like aura. Aura in Sanskrit is called Divya Kanti Valay. It is from Atharva Veda. You must have seen Guru Nanak, Jesus, or great lords and gurus. You must have find some colorful auras around gods and goddesses, a circle which is called halo. Truly, it is. Now it is possible through the help of science that it is visible around our entire body, and even ordinary human being is not away from aura. We all are having our aura. Problem is somebody or most of us leading a city life is having negative aura. Wherever our aura is, our mind remains there. It is possible to cleanse our aura, and it is possible to find out what is the defect in aura. It is just like shadow. Shadow is black, aura is colorful. You cannot avoid your aura. You cannot avoid your shadow. Similarly, you cannot avoid your aura. However, you can clean your aura and you can rectify your aura, and it will affect your body, mind and soul.
That's pretty much an insightful answer, sir. So getting on to the next question, sir, we talk about stress, that is how stress affects us mentally, how it affects us physically. But there also comes a point where it affects our soul also. So how would you explain that, you know, that stress is affecting our aura also?
Stress is part of modern city life. We must lead our life by good food, sattvic living and sattvic thoughts. Then only you can clean your aura. I know speaking is simple, but it is very difficult to maintain a healthy and disciplined life. But we will have to do. Aura cleansing is important to lead a successful life and to lead a stress-free life. Today, it is possible to lead a successful life and better life by cleansing your aura, which is not a rocket science. It all depends on your food and disciplined life.
So before I go to the other question, I want to tell our viewers that the session is open for comments. So you can ask as many questions as you want to, since sir is live with us right now. So don't miss this opportunity. And sir, next question to you is that how can one person actually better their aura? How can they make that positive change and cut all the negativity around them in their energy field?
Truly, aura begins with your physical body. Your physical body depends on your food and disciplined life. Do brisk morning walk, go to the sun, go to near five elements of the nature. Try to remain within sattvic food and sattvic area. You will lead a stress-free life.
So going on to our next question, since we're talking about how to maintain that calm and composure, but again, like when there is so much stress and when there are problems like one after the other, so the energy field is affected in every way possible, and then the aura gets distorted. So what is the way to keep that energy field calm and composed?
In modern world, in city life, our surroundings are very much crucial. They are entering our aura, and our aura gets defects. Electromagnetic waves are there. Schumann waves are there. The city life is full of electromagnetic waves and geomagnetic stress below the ground. Our first thing you should understand that our body is having four types of skin. First skin is our blood and skin, flesh, bones. Second is our clothes. Third is our roof, our structure where we are living in. Fourth is the atmosphere. Let us talk, begin with the first. If we do not have good morning walk, good morning bath, how can we talk about good food and clothes? So let us begin with good life since the morning. Five elements of the nature are basic elements. They deal with our body and mind. They also influence our thoughts, and they are most influential for our surroundings. Suppose I am working around with electromagnetic waves or near some mobile tower or having a place where geopathic stress is there. We cannot save ourselves. These days, computer and digital life has become most eminent for living. Unless the circumstances, we are curing ourselves daily. We cannot survive. So, vastu is important to live in harmony with nature. Food is important for our thoughts and physical body. Similarly, yoga and exercises are necessary to keep our body agile and with stress-less life.
That's pretty much insightful. So moving on to the next question, viewer Pallavi has a question which has two parts to it. So to begin with, the first part is, can we clean our aura physically? And if so, what is the use of salt in it? How can we clean the aura with salt, with the help of the salt?
Water and salt are part of life. But excess of anything is bad. Similarly, we have to regulate our water. In Sanskrit, there is a science called Sudhapan. How we can clean our body? Only through taking appropriate quantity of water. That is called Sudhapan. Sudha is called Amrit. So water is very important. And water depends on where you are living. In Jaipur, in Delhi, even 8 liters are not enough. Whereas in Frankfurt, 4 liters are good enough. So it is depending on where are you living and what are your nature of work. Those passing their lives in a air conditioning office, they can have 4 liters. But those who are toiling on the streets, they must have 6 to 8 liters. Similarly, salt is to taste, but here salt is important and rock salt is more important. So, salts are a variety, but we need salts for keeping our blood pressures balanced. So, their diet is important. For this, you should take advice of your medical advisor.
Okay. So moving on, children per se, they keep on going to different places, to school, to play with other children. So obviously, since aura is one thing which is also affected to the surroundings. So how would you suggest people that, they can clean their, they can help clean their children's aura? And there's a question by a viewer called Purnima.
Aura is very important for children as well as aged. Because for children, they should play in a healthy atmosphere, good garden, and as per their capabilities and age, they should play outdoor games and their aura will be good. Because they are coming up, they are in a growing age, they should take good food, do brisk exercises to clean their aura. Food, diet, everything is important and it will be like elixir of life.
So, moving on, this is our last question from our side, and the session is still open for the viewers. If you have any question, you can ask. Sir, so since I talked about the fact that children go to different places like schools and to play on the ground or whatever, and this so and it so happens that they take on other people's aura. So is it true that people can take other people's negative aura, or it can affect them? And if so, what is the key role of this entire the passing of negative aura to the other, and how can we actually survive this, and how can we deal with this?
I appreciate your this question. Very good question. I must thank the viewer. Truly, as I told you, the aura is in the body as well as in the space which is surrounding. So if we go to a negative place, the negative aura can influence the positive aura. It is just like children mixing with bad friends. They are picking bad habits. They are also picking dirty habits. Similarly, parents should see that they play in a proper playground and they do not go to negative places. That is the only. And once the aura is affected, you can see by their face, and if they go to a negative place continuously for 2 3 days, children are definitely going to fall sick. The basic thing is that they will behave in a different manner and they will lose their concentration. So aura cleansing for children, for keeping their concentration towards studies, is very much essential. It can be done by proper bath and off. Also, proper cleansing through crystals, through aroma, and good food.
So that was for children, of course, but what about adults per se? Like, how do they do it then?
Adults have many ways. First, adults have to do yoga, concentration, meditation, good food, good aroma, and good crystal therapy. A good oil massage will do very well, and aroma bath is very important. But above all is good habits of yoga and exercise.
So, sir, there is a viewer, her name is Mona, and she's asking that how is it possible for a normal human eye to see their aura? Like, how can we see our own aura?
We can see our own aura through simple digital photography. You take your photograph in a white background, in a white dress, send the photograph to us. We will say what is your aura, what is the defects, how it can be rectified, how it can be corrected. And it will not take more than 15 days to correct your aura. You will feel better. You will work hard. You will perform well. This is a self-analysis technique. We can help you. You can do it yourself in the normal course. Please ask questions.
So, there is this viewer, her name is Pooja, and she's asking that she's been having negative thoughts continuously. So, and it is hampering her aura. So what needs to be done for that?
First of all, for negative thoughts, you need to have a good sleep, followed by good bath, listen to good music, start from chirping of words, good music, then your soul will be cleaned, and before soul, your mind will be concentrated. For that, do yoga, take some oil bath, take aroma, use crystals, good food, sattvic food, negative thoughts give negative mind bent, and it begins with bad food and disturbed life, sleepless nights, and a night full of bad dreams.
Since you talk about the dreams and everything, there's another viewer, her name is Shreya, and she's asking that since negative and positive are the two main aspects of life, so is it possible that we can transform the aura? Because the aura will be of different colors, and it is said that you know, the better the aura, the lighter will be the color, and dense the aura, denser, the darker will be the color. So one, I want to ask if that is true, the color theory, and second, that how can one transform the color of their aura? How can one transform the negative aura to positive aura?
Practical life is black and white. Black and white. These two colors are the two opposites. Black is no energy. White and violet are full of positive energy. If we see the aura, we start from pink, that is weakest. Pink and gray are the weakest energy. Orange and red are stressful energy. Green and yellow are moderate, youthful energy. Indigo blue is very positive and good energy. Violet is highest energy. That is why we say that our route of conquering the aura begins with black or negativeness and ends at white or positiveness. So this colorful aura can be rectified through colorful objects like crystals, flowers, aroma, semi-precious and precious stones, and different types of quartz crystal, paintings, symbols, herbs, minerals, magic bricks, reflectors, color, energy shielders, essential oil. But ways are different. But it depends on how you are affected, with what you are affected. Similar will be the treatment. Same treatment is not applicable to others. But believe me, it begins with good body, well energetic food, sattvic living, good bath, good music, positive thoughts, essential things of life are concentration in your work, meditation, positive surroundings, and a life from natural world. Live in five elements of nature for good vastu, and good vastu gives you better aura. Remember, destiny is not by chance. It can be chosen. Simple by recitation of any religious mantra, you cannot achieve the highest of aura. It's a combination of all put into one.
Sir, so there is another user now, since you have given such colorful information about the colors of aura. So Sayogita is asking, what are the crystals that we need to use for aura cleansing?
It begins with your aura. Suppose I find your aura is red. And your aura is red means you are under stress. Stress aura, and I found that you are having a birth date where your earth sector is strong. So I will provide you the earth crystal, that is amethyst crystal. This amethyst crystal will be good for you and it will open your Muladhara chakra. Similarly, by astrology, by crystal astrology, by use of colors, I can change your aura by hitting your chakras. So all are together into one and they will affect your aura. And when I find that there will be positive changes, I will use then aroma of sandalwood in your navel, so that your Muladhara chakra goes up towards Swadhisthana. And I will also use the positive musical therapy. In this way, then I will give you mantras, beach mantras, so that it is truly, it is personalized. There is no general rule for cleansing your aura, but I use all the techniques to improve and enhance your aura from negativity to positivity.
And with this, we move on to our last question, sir. So we want to understand, as the last question comes to you now, that is, how is evil's eye connected to aura and if it can be rectified through it?
Yes, the question of evil eye or najar is very important. And there are people who have evil eyes, evil outlook. They are jealous. It depends on their thoughts. Suppose you are successful or your child is very beautiful. If you find that in spite of their sincere best efforts, they are not getting it, then you should use. And all our simple totkas and are good. Salt is important. Water is important. Light is important. This totkas, najar, evil eye, all are having different names in different cultures. But yes, they exist and we must fight it out with our positive thoughts, mantras and good concentration. First, don't allow it to enter your mind. Let it remain within your body and other thoughts. You can clean it through your positive mind, good mantras, good yogas and good disciplined life. But there are many ways by which it can be cleaned. Rock salt and good crystals, effective crystals like citrine and sandalwood or rosewood aroma are very important to clean this, along with colors. And there are many ways and each way is different, depends on human nature, their type of daily life. It can be done right from good posture to relaxation and good sleep.
Very thankful to Dr. Surendra Kapoor for such insightful information on aura and aura cleansing. So with this, we'll say goodbye to all our viewers. And you can still log on to our Facebook and we can comment and you can ask questions and he'll be happy to reply. And also, I would request to keep logging in to Speaking Tea every day for more such insights and amazing videos. With that, I'll say goodbye to you. Namaste.